So I've been getting fed up with my LG G5. It's had some issues. Mainly video playback was causing the whole UI to just crash. And it causes apps to crash. And not only that, but the GPS. Well, it's an LG G5. Do you expect the GPSs on those things to actually work? Exactly. The G5s have the worst GPSs. They just lose signal all the time. It's even worse than my BlackBerry Priv was. But, went to Target. Found this baby on clearance, the Orbic Wonder 5.5-inch smartphone for Android, certified on all major carriers. Well, this isn't too big of an issue because I've got Cricket and that's a GSM carrier, so any phone's going to work. But this should pick up the 4G LTE bands Cricket uses. So let's flip this over to the side here. It says unlocked all the way. Betcha it's some rebranded Chinese phone like the blue phones are, but the blue phones are pretty crummy. This, on the other hand, for $100, I'm getting a 13 megapixel camera, quick charge 2.0, and yeah, it also has fingerprint recognition, which even cheap phones have nowadays, but I don't like fingerprint recognition because it's a bit easy to cheat, if you know what I mean. But yeah, here's an Android phone. I think this comes with like Android 7.1 or something. So yeah, let's take this thing apart and see what's in it. Or, well, the box apart. Alright, so I've removed a piece of plastic tape. I've removed the plastic cover this was in at Target. Now let's see what's in here. Let's see what's in this phone. Okay, yeah. So, we get the phone in here. Orbic. Nice. Quick start guide. Here's a safety and warranty guide for this. Here's the charger. It actually looks quite beefy. This is a AC-DC charger, Orbic branded, but it's a quick charge charger, so it's actually quite big. Better than whatever crummy crap I was using. This is actually a USB-C phone. As you can see here, this is a USB-C phone. This is not USB A or B mini. And it does have a headphone jack because it comes with these headphones. But it looks like the battery is sealed like a lot of these modern phones sadly are. That's a fingerprint reader, not a home button. So let's take the phone out of the plastic. So as we can see here, it's got all the specs written here. 13 megapixel camera, fingerprint, octa-core Qualcomm, 5.5 inch screen, Android 7.1. As you can see, it's quite big. This is a big, big phone, so you might definitely want a case for this if you can find one. 13 megapixel, 16 gigs of ROM, and 2 gigs of RAM, but you can put a microSD in here. Now keep in mind, this does mean that the phone's a little behind the curve, but I only paid $100 for this, so can you really complain? As you can see, it's got the typical Android phone look, the little wannabe iPhone look with the metal back, and a camera right here covered up by plastic. So yeah, looks like an everyday Android phone. I mean, too many of them, but it does have a headphone jack, unlike the iPhone. Alright, let's turn this thing on. Oh, that was the volume down button. And it still has a charge. It says Orbic, powered by Android, like all these phones have to nowadays. And, let's see what it does. Let's see how fast the first boot is. I'm curious. I mean, some of these first boots can be interesting. Orbic. Now, some of these first boots can be interesting because I got my mom like a cheap LG recently, and that thing, when it first turned on, it actually said erasing. So this one starts up pretty quick. I'm going to skip the SIM card setup for now. Let's get fresh start. And I'm going to see all Wi-Fi networks. I don't think this is 5. Oh, it is actually 5 gigahertz. So yeah, let's enter a password in. And it's checking for updates. You're probably not going to get any because this is a generic Android phone. But whatever, I mean, I was using a phone with 4.4 temporarily, so this phone should still last some time anyway. so I'm gonna skip all this for now. Don't send system data. I don't care about that. All set. And then I'm gonna check ISAT. So right here, this phone is stock Android. Very stock Android. As stock as it gets. That's what this phone runs. Stock Android, it's as stock as it gets. Has 6 gigs used right out of the gate. It has that very stock Android feel. This has Android 7.1.2. But it really does have that stock Android feel. Like that very plain stock Android feel. Screen looks quite good. The screen looks like it's actually pretty good. It's got that... it's got that Duo thing. I don't know what Duo is, but it looks like a camera thing. Sort of. Let's open up the camera. Deny. I don't want this camera to spy on me. Okay. So the camera on this phone looks decent. Camera on the phone doesn't look too bad. Let me just go to settings real quick. And let's see what, like... Okay, that's a little weird. Let's go to here. Let's go to video. And let's go here. I'm just curious what it can do. So it can only do 1080p. Which is pretty much expected with these phones. But the quality doesn't look so bad. This actually looks like a decent quality video recorder, for sure. I'll have to play with this a bit more, but it doesn't look like it's that bad. Especially considering how I only paid $100 for this. So... yeah. All in all, this seems like a nice, fast, snappy phone. For just $100. You can't complain for that. It's unlocked, too, so... all I gotta do now is put my SIM in it, and this'll be a fun phone for a while. So, yeah. There's my review of this Orbic, what's it called? I don't know. I gotta look at the box again. The Orbic Wonder. Yeah, that's my review, the Orbic Wonder. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more gamers. Alright, so I've been using this phone for a bit, and it's actually quite a nice phone. So let's talk about a few other aspects of this phone now that I've been using it for about a day or so. Now keep in mind this was a $100 phone. It blows out a lot of those prepaid $100 phones you can find at Walmart or Target in the prepaid section, and it definitely blows these other crappy phones out of the water, like the unlocked phones you find at Walmart, that is, the real bottom-of-the-barrel ones, like the blue phones. There's some real crappy blue phones. For example, it even, like, pops up when you get a notification. It actually fades the screen in. So there are some of these real crappy blue phones out there, like the ones with, like, 8 gigs of storage and a gig of RAM and some old version of Android and some bad camera, like... some of the ones you'll find at Target, for example, they only have, like, Android 5.1. They've got a horrible, horrible CPU, RAM, storage, and all that. They were even worse a while back, but they're selling stuff for, like, $80, $70-ish dollars. They're selling stuff like that that is worse than even some of the bottom-of-the-barrel prepaid phones, like some of the cheapest track phones and whatnot. So this is actually pretty good for the price. So let me point out one fun feature about it first. The selfie camera also has a flash. Now this is a feature that a lot of, like, even some flagships don't have this, but you can actually take selfies with the flash and all. And that's a fun feature right there. You can actually take selfies with the flash of the camera. So, you see there's a camera, there's the selfie flash. You can actually take selfies with that. That's kind of nice. Camera here also has a flash. This camera's a 13 megapixel. It's not that great, especially in low light. But it does take usable pictures. I mean, they're usable. You're not going to get, like, a Samsung or a LG or a Pixel or an iPhone or even, like, the real high-end Chinese phone quality camera out of this. You're not going to get the highest of the highest quality. There's no dual lenses. There's no 4K video. It's just 1080p30. But it does have a micro SD slot, and it does record acceptable quality photos. I think that's how I'm going to describe it, because when you get into, like, dark stuff, there's a lot of noise and whatnot. So this is the Orbic phone. It actually looks quite nice, though. Like I said, it's got that premium look to it. Like, this originally sold for $200, so this blows out, like, a lot of the cheaper, like, Android phones that are prepaid out of the water. Like, even, like, the Moto E's cost more than I paid for this. This was only $100. So, yeah. IPS screen, pretty nice. It really is an IPS screen, it seems. And also, let's unlock this first. And let's switch over to the app. CPU-Z. So as we can see here, 1080p screen, 2 gigs of RAM, like it's on the box. Qualcomm Snapdragon 435. This is a nice octa-core CPU, better than some of the junk that you find on low-end phones. So the one I got for my mom, which is a Boost mobile phone. That phone does, in fact, have a MediaTek 8-core, but this has a Qualcomm 8-core too. It's also a decent CPU. It seems pretty snappy and whatnot. Says Manufacturer's Reliance, and that's the company that that owns Orbic, I think. But brand Orbic and all that. Now, it does run Android 7.1.2. I think there might be a software update for it, but the thing that's interesting about this phone is this. Now, I did research about Reliance and who they are, and apparently this phone was manufactured by Unimax, or UMX. This was a phone made by Unimax, or it was manufactured by them for this company. So either this is a rebranded Unimax phone, or it is a original design that Unimax manufactured for Orbic. Interesting. So here's one negative quirk about this phone. If you look for cases for this phone, you're not going to find anything at all. You're just going to find a case that says currently unavailable on Amazon that looks like it was manufactured by Orbic themselves. And because this phone was so obscure, you're not going to find much for it. You're going to find iPhone cases, Galaxy cases, but you're not going to find cases for this phone. You're going to find screen protectors, sure, but you're not going to find cases. And you're just going to see people asking about fit, a comment that says Orbic is the only provider of accessories for this phone, and issues with this phone, basically. Basically, this phone case seem to have some issues with this very same phone. So, not a good thing. And when I looked on eBay, I did find a case I ordered from China, but it looks to be one of those generic one-size-fits-all cases, which doesn't even cover, like, the back half of the phone. And it leaves the ports uncovered because it's just a generic one-size-fits-all case for other 5.5-inch smartphones. This is a big, nice, big 5.5-inch phone. It looks nice. Like, it really does. But here's another quirk about this phone that's worth mentioning, okay? So by now, if you've bought unlocked phones, you probably know that most are designed for basically two out of the four American networks. You get support on AT&T, support on T-Mobile, but you're not going to get support on, like, Verizon or Sprint. And if you get, like, something like a blue phone, it's going to be even worse because there's no LTE bands. Or if you get a Chinese phone, it'll only support LTE bands outside America, which isn't a problem if you're in, like, Europe, isn't a problem if you're in Asia, isn't a problem if you're in some, like, other part of the world, like Africa, the Middle East, or South America. But if you're in North America, this is a problem because our frequencies are different, and there are so many LTE frequencies across the world that usually with those cheap phones, they only cover the most popular worldwide ones, which lacks American ones. This one not only has American LTE frequencies, which is already a good sign, this has CDMA frequencies, and it has support for Sprint and Verizon. That's right, this phone not only works on Verizon, but it works on Sprint. or it says it does. I did see a review online claiming this phone doesn't work on Sprint MVNOs, like the brands that use Sprint. I tried this, it didn't work, all that stuff. So this might not work on Sprint, and I know some of their MVNOs, like Boost Mobile, are very, very picky about what phones they'll accept onto their network. Like, they're even pickier than Sprint themselves, as Boost is, that is. But this phone works great for Verizon, I've heard. It works great on Cricket or AT&T, which is why I'm using it. It should work fine on T-Mobile. And here's something fun about this phone, okay? So this phone right here, this phone basically has, I've heard that Verizon is actually going to release a prepaid variation of this phone, which would make sense because of the whole CTE stuff and the whole ZTE being made to halt production almost. The Huawei and ZTE being pressured by the governments not for, like, companies not to buy their stuff, which probably was a disappointment because all these, like, phone companies loved purchasing ZTE phones. They loved purchasing Huawei phones for, like, the prepaid market. So now they're having to go to companies like Unimax. They're having to go to companies like Coolpad. Some of them, like AT&T, are even going to companies nobody's heard of. Like, I actually saw some AT&T branded phone from a company that I actually did the research on. It's some absolute no-name company. I'd have to do more research on it to see who made it, but I did the research on this one. This one's made by Unimax, who seems to make a decent amount of phones for, like, the prepaid market and all that. I mean, they had a phone online, which was, like, AT&T branded. They brand some of their phones from, like, the UMX brand. I've seen, like, some government welfare phones, or Obama phones, as people call them, branded as UMX. So they're a decent Chinese phone maker. At least they seem to make, they've been making phones for a good few years now. They're not, like, starting out. So this is actually made by a slightly more known Chinese company. I say slightly more known because you're not going to find these phones, like, Huawei's or ZTE's on, like, GearBest or anything. You're just going to find, like, you might not even find this on GearBest. You'd find this phone at, like, Target or Walmart, which is where I picked this up. I picked this up at Target, and it seems to be a decent phone so far. Only other issue is the battery sealed, like every damn smartphone these days, except the really low-end ones. So if the battery ever goes, you're screwed. And good luck finding even a replacement battery for this, because this company is so obscure. I mean, who's heard of Orbic, to be honest? But who knows, they might, like, become like Blue one day, but making less shitty phones. Because they've been selling these phones at, like, stores like Target to the unlocked phone demographic. So who wants an alternative to, like, some of the crummy, boring phones you get from, like, the prepaid line? So this is a decent alternative to those phones. I mean, it's $100. You can't go wrong with that. You don't have to worry about ordering a phone online, like, if you're buying a used phone, and then having to worry about, does this phone have issues? Like, the first LG G5 I had was, like, it was all screwed up. The mic didn't even work. Second LG G5 works great, but that phone's got some, like, the GPS doesn't work, which it works on here, it seems. I'd have to actually put it to the test, though, but I don't need to because my car's got a GPS, and that other phone was crashing while playing back YouTube videos, so, that kind of sucks. So, yeah, all in all, decent phone for $100 at Target, so what else can I say? This phone's nice and snappy. And it has a nice screen. That's all that needs to be said. And it has USB-C. Which a lot of these cheap prepaid phones don't have. And it has quick charge. Can't beat that for $100. I mean, you get these phones which just are USB-B, B micro USB. That's what they're, micro USB-B, and no quick charge. And this has both of them for $100. Now, can you beat that? Let's be honest here. You can't really beat that, can you? That's all that needs to be said. Nice, nice phone. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more. I mean, maybe if you subscribe, I could show you some of my weirder junk, like this PC98. I'll get this working one day. I need another keyboard. I got rid of my last PC98, but subscribe if you want to see more cool tech videos. I've got some on the way.